Okay, so this video is going to focus on how to solve absolute value equations. So when it comes to absolute value, so first off, when it comes to understanding some of these equations, it helps to understand what absolute value actually represents. So the definition of absolute value says that it is the distance a number is away from zero. So if you think about distance, the main thing about absolute value that most people do remember about absolute value is that absolute value is always positive. If you have something inside absolute value that's negative, it always turns positive. And that makes sense because you can't have a negative distance. If you're measuring something, it's always positive. It always has a positive length. There's no such thing as like negative 5 feet or anything like that. So absolute value bars is always positive. So when it comes to solving absolute value equations, technically when it comes to our variable, you need to think then, well, how do we know if this value inside of here was really positive or really negative? Because the absolute value bars is always going to turn it positive, but what did it start out with? Did it start out negative? Did it start out positive? And that's kind of what we need to take into consideration when we solve these. So when we solve absolute value equations, first off, you're always going to have two equations, right? You take one equation and you take into consideration the positive side of it, and then the other equation represents the negative side over here. So this is the way that looks like. So we're going to split this into two equations. The first equation is always the regular, normal-looking equation the way that it is there. So that would be 2x plus 1 is equal to 9. The other equation is going to be our negative aspect of it. So the left side is still always going to stay the same, but we're going to set it equal to the negative value. So instead of it equaling 9, we're going to set it equal to negative 9. And these are the two equations that we need to solve. So solving these two equations, we subtract 1 on both sides. 1 minus 1 cancels, and we drop down the 2x is equal to 9 minus 1 is 8. Divide out the coefficients, and we get that x is equal to 4. Solve the other equation. So here we would subtract 1 on both sides, and we get that 2x is equal to a negative 10. And then divide out the coefficient to get that x is equal to a negative 5. Now, most of the time, you do need to graph your solutions when it comes to absolute value equations. And really, honestly, sometimes before you even get to the graph, you would want to check to be sure, are these solutions correct? Every once in a while, when it does come to absolute value, you are left with an answer that doesn't end up working. So with absolute value equations, you do always want to take your answers here and plug them back in and check to see if they're correct. So for example, if we plug in a 4 for x, so that would be a 4 times a 2, which is 8, and 8 plus 1 is 9, so we're good there. If we plugged in the negative 5, negative 5 times 2 is a negative 10, negative 10 plus 1 is a negative 9, but if we take the absolute value of negative 9, it equals 9. So both equations do check out. And most of the time they will, but every once in a while you do have one that turns out not to be. So you do need to get in the habit of checking your solutions every time. Otherwise, when we go to graph these, so x equals 4, it also equals negative 5. So here's a 4 and a negative 5. Now this is equals, so equals is just a dot on it, so a dot on negative 5, a dot on 4. So these are the two solutions that these represent here.